The way that we handle recycling and sustainability and waste management in the US is fundamentally broken. The model that we've employed to manage municipal waste is the same model that we employed all the way back in the years of the Romans. And that is to take all the waste, all the stuff that we don't want, and stick it in a big hole in the ground.
When our residents, when consumers, when they put their waste out on a curb and the truck comes by and empties their cart, for them, right, it just went away. But the thing is there's no such thing as away. There'll come a day when our natural resources are in such short supply because we didn't design them to be recycled. We'll be digging that stuff out of landfills.
During my previous job working on climate change, I visited numerous landfills, including landfills in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, the Kosh landfill there, and in Johannesburg, South Africa, as well as landfills around the US. And that experience showed to me just how painful and how challenging siting these landfills in various communities can be.
Landfills are designed to have the least amount of impact on groundwater and on air as they can. Nonetheless, our waste now is full of all kinds of toxic ingredients, household chemicals, pesticides, herbicides, automotive chemicals. Those things shouldn't go in your trash, but they do, and they are going to produce more leachate. That's the liquid that all mixes together, the kind of trash stew in a landfill, and then they're going to produce more landfill gases from decomposition. Methane gas is a byproduct of decomposition.
Methane is 30 to 80 times more potent in the atmosphere than carbon, but methane provides the best opportunity for us to reduce our greenhouse gas emissions in the short term. We can actually avoid 0.3 degrees Celsius warming as a result of reducing methane. Cities are key to helping us to reduce our emissions overall. The way that they are going to do that is by delivering services and delivering the day-to-day infrastructure in the most efficient way possible.
I've been on recycling probably for like 14 years, and I knew it was going to go somewhere, so I liked picking up the bins even when it was on the ground and throwing them over the top of the truck and getting my exercise for that day, but, you know, lots changed.
In this industry, we're considered the garbage man. I like to consider myself as a garbologist. Our routes average between 800 to 900 homes serviced per day. So if all the trucks are rolling with no problems, we can usually get the route done. If not, then that's where we have to start helping each other.
When I first got here, there wasn't anything kind of modern or sophisticated to efficiently route or to track whether or not collections had happened. If anybody said their trash was missed, you know, we had a lot of go-backs, and that's expensive and also a little bit demoralizing at the end of a day.
You go out there, you do your route, you think you do a good job.
And the supervisor approaches you and says, we have all these missed pickups.
It was between about 50 and 60 complaints a day. It was pretty wild how thick that stack would be.
It's time-consuming, uses unnecessary fuels. It's costly to the city as far as hourly wages.
So having technology to help us track those things was very attractive.
The way Rubicon is fixing this model is through aligning the incentives in the waste industry. So that's really the reason that Rubicon exists. And we have a long track record over the last 12 years of helping customers save money by diverting more waste away from landfill. The garbage truck is unique among municipal fleets because it's the only vehicle that goes up and down every single street in the city at least once a week. If we equip the garbage truck with the right technology, we can actually allow a municipal government to be proactive in the way that it delivers service. Our system is cloud-based, so the technology can be taken in and out of the vehicles. It runs on any smartphone. And that smartphone runs our proprietary app that we've designed for drivers and supervisors to communicate back with their headquarters and to log issues in the field.
When you come across an issue, for an example, you come to a container that's overloaded, contaminated load, broken container.
Let's say you see tree branches sticking out of a recycling bin. I'll open the bin, take a picture, submit it, and it goes straight to the office.
So when a customer calls and maybe they say their cart wasn't collected, we can look right on there and see exactly where the driver is on the route and say, well, you know, that driver was by your house at 8:30 this morning and your cart was supposed to be out at 8. So pull your cart out next week on time and we'll see you then.
Shirley is one of Rubicon's longest customers. The city of Santa Fe has been one of our customers for years now.
We did a pilot project with Rubicon. In their early days, we were one of their beta cities.
They were very instrumental as far as helping us to understand their needs.
Because as we've asked for things, they've developed the software side and implement them. And so it's just been a great partnership.
Hey, Shirley.
Hey, Fred, welcome.
How's it going?
Good to see you.
Good to see you too. What we're doing now with Santa Fe is working on a fleet optimization, taking into consideration routes, personnel, resources such as their vehicles, and working all of that in so that we can produce a much more efficient operation.
I'm really excited to know what are the updates on the route optimization.
Oh, sure, yeah. You're probably about a month or two away from actually running some test routes.
That is so exciting.
Waste can often be one of the top five costs that a municipality faces. And waste collection is the most expensive part. And so a lot of cities are looking for ways that they can pick up the trash as efficiently as possible and then use that savings to focus on recycling and recycling education.
I've noticed a big change in the community. Hardly anybody would recycle here. Once we went automated, the percentages in recycling went high. It was kind of a lot for us to handle at first, and then we got used to it.
We've been working on developing technology to actually detect recycling contamination at the source. What we've developed is a machine learning model that actually recognizes materials as they are dumped into the hopper and then provides alerts that a particular load has been contaminated. Once we can start to narrow down where the contamination is happening, that allows us to target recycling education material and then actually improve its effectiveness.
When I talk about redesigning our systems, which sounds really huge, but that's how we'll get to zero waste. People talk about the term circular economy. You manufacture something, you use the product, you can recycle it or compost it, and whatever's left becomes the raw material for the next product. That's the kind of system we're going to need in order to get to zero waste.
Our entire solution is cloud-based. We use the AWS cloud to power all of our technology solutions. We have a number of machine learning models that we've developed in SageMaker to do everything from confirming service to being able to do things like detect potholes and overflowing bins. So machine learning is really at the heart of our vision of a smarter city, and that all is enabled by our work with AWS. The challenges that Santa Fe has been working on are the same challenges that many, many American cities face. We recently completed a fleet optimization for the city of Atlanta. In that operation, we were actually able to save the city about $700,000. We were also able to save them about 4,000 tons of emissions. I'm very hopeful at our ability to overcome some of these challenges when it comes to climate change. As we scale, greenhouse gas emissions related to waste collection will go down. More efficient cities are a key to solving climate change.
I know that I'm a part of a team that is working for a better environment for not only myself, my family, for future generations.
We all realize we have a role to play in climate change. If you look at it holistically, it's a daunting task. But if we all just figure out we play our small role, collectively, we will get there.
The more we recycle, the more it's gonna help our landfill and the gases that go up in the air. So I feel with Rubicon here, getting the customers to recycle in the right way, I see things improving, yes.
And there are days I feel like I've been doing the same thing for 20 years and nothing's happened. But then I look around and I realize there are a lot of people who care, for the first time, there's multiple legislation addressing a national recycling system. We need to go a little faster, but the hopeful thing is that these conversations are finally happening.